Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Ignacio Salazar, the Chief Executive Officer at Highfield Resources. And a very warm welcome to you, Ignacio. How are you doing?
Thanks. Good afternoon, Tom. Good to be here.
It's good to have you on. And we've just found out that you have received your last construction license for your Muga Potash project in Spain. So tell us what it means for the project.
Correct. A very, very important milestone. I mean, the company has been for several years now in the normal permitting phase of this project. We started construction last year. We will come back to that, I guess, later in the discussion, but very much going through this process in Europe in general, in Spain, not necessarily an easy process, but I think we can say with confidence we turned the page on that phase. We closed the chapter with this last license. We got the mining concession, the environmental permit, the license from the other region. So this is the last one. With this, we can move into construction of the bulk of the mine, of the project, and all the facilities. Very, very glad to get to this point.
Fantastic. Well, you're obviously very pleased with the news. So last time we spoke, you mentioned that you were doing some work on the decline access area. So how's that gone?
Yes, so we got, as I mentioned before, this license. I mean, the project is sitting between two regions. So once we had the mining concession in 2021, we got from one of the regions where the mine is sitting the construction license. We were missing the one that we got yesterday night, which is where the processing plant is sitting. So we started all the work around the mine gate a few days after we got that license last year, and we were working for the second half of the year on that. We finished at the end of the year, beginning of this year. A small piece of work is all the work around the mine gate, but I think that has been a strategic move. We got 6 months ahead in the work related to the ramps. That is always is a bit more difficult, less flexible to work there rather than in the plant. Plant and ramps have to be run in parallel. But we are, as I said, with this, we can continue in that air region and we can, work in parallel on the processing plant as well.
Understood. So you've obviously done an enormous amount of work to get to this point, but you do now have to start drumming up some more money. So what's the plan there?
While we've been doing that, it's been also a lot of work as well on the financing side. The financing strategy, as we call, is an important project. It's a CapEx, according to our feasibility study, 400 million euros for this phase. So we got already, and we've been working for a year and a half of the diligence with four European banks to get 320 million secure and committed for us, for the project, in terms of project finance. We announced that at the end of 2022, and that is ready and available for us, and have been working also with the strategic investors. I think everybody on the investor community, on the local community, and as well in our partners or potential partners, strategic partners, were waiting for this license. So that puts the company in a position of strength to negotiate any further deals. So things are a lot of work behind us, very satisfactory conditions, terms and conditions of the project finance, and now I think ready in a much better position to complete the financing for the project indeed.
Fantastic. So beyond the financing, what else do you need to achieve before construction finally begins in earnest, Ignacio?
No, we have been already for a bit of time fully prepared. Obviously, have been holding our breath, if you wish, waiting for this final license and to complete the financing strategy, but I'm engineering ready. We are very much in discussions with contractors, have been preparing tendering. We updated the feasibility study as well at the end of last year, and I think with very positive outcome, again, reconfirming very, special and exceptional economics of the project, despite updating the inflation numbers from last year and also the discipline the banks imposed on the due diligence that was incorporated. Practically, we reconfirmed the numbers that we had 1 year before. And the only thing that happened, hopefully, in 2023 and is happening is prices becoming cheaper, no? Especially gas, electricity, things like that. So we need to sort of re-engage with the contractors, start build this construction team. It's not only the 30 people here in the office in Highfield. This is going to be a 1,000 people construction effort, and together with contractors, suppliers, local suppliers, simply to re-engage, prepare ourselves, get the plan firm up and start construction.
Very exciting. Well, Ignacio, we'll be keeping a close eye, and hopefully it won't be long before we get another update from you. But until then, thank you very much for your time.
Thanks a lot to you, Tom, and glad to be here, and looking forward to the next few steps for Highfield. Thank you.